In the struggle for survival, humanity persists in its relentless assault on nature by insisting on activities that affect the climate. These activities encompass the emission of polluted air, the burning of fossil fuels, the unyielding obliteration of forests, the encroachment upon wetlands and water bodies, and the utilization of harmful methods of mineral extraction. Together, these actions contribute to the alarming acceleration of global warming. Curiously, within this predicament, there exist often overlooked practices that further undermine the protective layers shielding our cherished planet. Specifically, the significance of air conditioners and refrigerators has surged in our daily lives. Refrigerants release chemical compounds known as chlorofluorocarbons, which disturb the ozone layer when released into the atmosphere. The president of Uganda National Association of Refrigeration and Air Conditioning breaks down the chemicals that deplete the ozone layer and what they are phasing out.
The first phase out of chemicals were called CFC, chlorofluorocarbon. Those are chemicals which has got element of chlorine, and which are very dangerous to the ozone layer. And it has been replaced now by hydrocarbons, refrigerant called 600A, 290, 290. Those ones were called HSC, hydrocarbons. And they are good, they don't deplete the ozone. They don't also global warm.
To further understand the role these electronics play in global warming and ways to mitigate it, a team from the National Environment Management Authority paid a visit to Gayaza Electronic Works Limited in Kampala. The machines here are said to be devoid of any harmful chemical compounds that have the propensity to disturb the delicate ozone layer.
This is a very important project, and it's a model for Uganda. It is only the second industry of the type in Africa. First one is in Botswana, second one here. Contributing to global reduction in ozone depleting substances.
In what manner does the ozone layer's deterioration caused by the chemical substances emitted from refrigerators and air conditioners affect the well-being of individuals?
It protects us from the dangerous rays that come from the sun. Those dangerous rays, when they get touches you, can destroy your skin, cause changes that can result into cancer, and destroy your eyes, create cataracts, and can also destroy plants. So you know, when resources, you as a human being is destroyed, of course you can die. Your plants are destroyed, you lose crops with food insecurity.
In a momentous shift from chlorofluorocarbons in the manufacturing of refrigerators and air conditioners, researchers have unearthed a novel chemical alternative that presents zero harm to the ozone layer.
Awareness. We have so much information lying around us. But what is it about climate change that is rocket science? It is not rocket science. It is a simple thing. We can think globally but act locally.
The ozone layer is a thin part of Earth's atmosphere that absorbs almost all of the sun's harmful ultraviolet lights. And now for some facts about the ozone layer. A significant reduction in the consumption of ozone-depleting substances has been achieved globally since 1986. This reduction has largely been driven by the 1987 United Nations Environment Programme Montreal Protocol. The largest historical extent of the ozone hole, 28.4 square kilometers, occurred in September 2000. This area is equivalent to almost seven times the territory of the EU. In late September 2022, the Antarctic ozone hole reached its maximum area of 24.5 square kilometers. Up until early November 2022, the Antarctic ozone hole has been similarly large and long-lasting to the ones recorded in 2021 and 2020. Report by Jimmy Luima for the news.